Hello. This tutorial is designed to give you a short description about what ToxoDB is. So ToxoDB, which can be accessed at toxodb.org, is a functional genomic online resource which allows you to run searches against a underlying database. Now, I know this sounds kind of complicated, but it's really just like any other website that you use online, like Amazon, for example, which allows you to search for books and clothing items. What's happening is when you go to the Amazon website, you are looking at a website, at an online resource, which lets you search the underlying database of book names and clothing types and shoes and so forth. And in this case, ToxoDB is essentially the same thing. It's an online website which allows you to now run different searches against a genome. In the case of Toxoplasma or ToxoDB, it contains many different genomes from different organisms. They're all organisms that cause diseases in humans and in animals. It gets its name from the organism Toxoplasma gondii, which can cause disease in humans and animals alike. It includes the genomes of all of these organisms and a lot of different types of data that's associated with the genomes. For example, all these genomes have genes, right? They have thousands of genes, and each of these genes has a specific ID. That ID is almost like a zip code, or like a street address for a particular house. That'll be the same thing for a gene. So if we look up here, a gene ID, if you knew the gene ID for a specific gene, you can type it in and you can go specifically to that gene and take a look at it, that gene page, and which then, imagine the description of a book, that'll be the description of the gene. And so I'm going to go ahead and click on this. And there's already a default ID here. If you click on this, you will see that it takes you to a particular gene. And there's a lot of information here, which I won't go into the details, just to tell you that it's almost like a catalog of information about this gene. And so if you were in Amazon and you searched for a specific book, you would get to the page that describes the book with all the information surrounding that book. This database also allows you to run searches based on words. So for example, I can search for any gene in any of the genomes in this database that has the word kinase, for example, right? And kinase is just a name for a type of protein that phosphorylates other proteins. And if I type the word kinase, you can and run the search, instead of getting a single gene back, as we did with the specific ID, we're getting many genes. So we get close to 4,000 genes that are found in ToxoDB, and they're distributed amongst the different organisms in ToxoDB. So all of these, Imeria, Hamandia, Neospora, Sarcocystis, Toxoplasma, these are all different organisms, and there are multiple species from each of these organisms, and each of these organisms has its own genome that's been sequenced, and each of the sequences or genomes has thousands of genes in them with different names for the genes. And so each one of these genes has the word kinase associated with it somehow will be returned from the search. And so if we were really only interested in Toxoplasma gondii, we can go ahead and click on Toxoplasma gondii, and all we will get is results from Toxoplasma gondii. Okay, so going back to the homepage, you will notice that there are also many additional searches that you can run against the genome. And so if you expand all of these, you'll see that there are many. And anytime you go to any of these searches, there'll be options available to you. So you can, for example, look for genes based on the number of exons they have. And if you click on this, you will see here that you have options. You can ask for which organisms you're interested in, and then define the number of exons you're interested in. And so, for example, I can change these numbers to 7 and 8. So let's say you only want genes that have at least 7 exons and no more than 8, and you run the search, you will get back a number of genes that meet these characteristics, right? And so that's information. So imagine you just ran a search in Amazon for any book that is a murder mystery, right? You will get a few hundred books, and then you can sort through them in different ways. Okay, so there are many, many different types of searches and tools available. And in the end, you're searching information and data surrounding the underlying genomes. And ToxoDB is specific for some of these genomes, including the organism Toxoplasma gondii.